Welcome to a video on the trigonometric functions in terms of the angles of rotation. So if we consider the following angle, let's call this angle theta from here to here. In standard position that intersects a circle with radius r at the point xy, you can think of the radius as the hypotenuse of the triangle formed by dropping this perpendicular to the x-axis. And because of the relationship between the three sides of a right triangle based upon the Pythagorean theorem, we can state that r squared is equal to x squared plus y squared, again r being the hypotenuse, so r would equal the principal square root of x squared plus y squared. So using this right triangle for our angle theta, which is actually called a reference triangle, we can define the trigonometric functions in terms of x, y, and r. Again, just keep in mind that if this is our angle theta and this is our triangle, y would actually be the opposite side. R, again, is the hypotenuse, which leaves x to be the adjacent side. So we're going to state these in terms of x, y, and r, but essentially we are using the same thing we did in the last video where sine theta would be opposite over hypotenuse, but now the opposite side is y and the hypotenuse is r. Cosine theta, instead of stating it as adjacent over hypotenuse, is now x over r. And tangent theta, instead of stating it as opposite over adjacent, would now be y over x. And then just remember that cosecant theta is the reciprocal of sine theta. So instead of y over r, we have r over y. And for secant theta, which is the reciprocal of cosine theta, we have r over x instead of x over r. And again, cotangent theta is the reciprocal of tangent theta, so we have x over y instead of y over x. So using this acronym SOHCAHTOA will also help you remember these. You just have to remember that when we sketch our triangle, we use x, y's, and r's instead. Now if the terminal sides of the angles do not fall in the first quadrant, we need to pay close attention to the sine of x and y, because the sine of the x and y will affect the sine of the trigonometric functions. We know that both x and y are positive in the first quadrant, so all trigonometric functions will be positive. But over in the second quadrant, the x is negative and the y is positive. Of course, this will affect the sine of cosine and tangent and their reciprocals. In the third quadrant, both x and y are negative, and this will affect sine and cosine and their reciprocals. And then in quadrant 4, the x coordinate is positive, the y is negative, so this will affect the sine of the sine function as well as the tangent function and their reciprocals. So here's an example of it. Consider the terminal side of the angle in standard position that passes through the point 8, negative 6. Find the values of the six trigonometric functions. So first we would plot our angle in standard position, which would be this. But remember, to form the reference triangle that we're going to use to find these values, we drop a perpendicular to the closest x-axis, which is here. So we're actually going to use this angle to determine the values of the trigonometric functions for this angle. So we can see that the x-coordinate is 8, so this distance here would be 8, and the y-coordinate is negative 6, so even though we think of distance as positive, we are going to use a signed integer to represent this as negative 6. Now the next thing we should recognize is the hypotenuse is missing, which we will call r. So remember from the previous screen, r is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. Let's find that. So we have 64 plus 36, which equals the square root of 100. So r is equal to 10, and r is always positive. That's all the information we need to find the six trigonometric functions for this angle. Sine theta would be y over r, or negative 6 over 10, which simplifies to negative 3/5. Cosine theta would be x over r, which would be 8 over 10, or 4/5. And tangent theta is y over x, negative 6/8, which simplifies to negative 3/4. once we have these, we can just identify the reciprocal functions. So cosecant theta would be negative 5/3. Secant theta would be 5/4. And cotangent theta would be negative 4/3. So just pay close attention to the sine of x and y, and it's pretty much the same as the last video. Now the circle, the terminal side of an angle intersects, can be any circle. However, often it is useful to use a circle with radius 1. And this is called the unit circle. And using the unit circle to find the values of the trigonometric functions does simplify our work slightly, because now if we know r is 1, we can conclude the following. Instead of stating sine theta as y over r, well, that would just be y over 1, which is equal to y. So we can find the value of sine theta by looking at just the y-coordinate as long as we know it's the unit circle. And the same thing for cosine theta. Instead of stating it as x over r, well, if r is 1, cosine theta equals x on the unit circle, and there's no change for tangent theta, it will still be y over x. And then again, here we have the reciprocal trigonometric functions. Instead of y, we have 1 over y for cosecant theta. Instead of x, we have 1 over x for secant theta. And for cotangent theta, we have x over y. Here's a nice tool to visualize the unit circle. Here we have any angle that intersects the unit circle. And as you see, the x value would be cosine theta, and the y value would be sine theta for any angle that intersects this unit circle. You can also see the nice reference triangles here that are formed with the x-axis. Again, because we have the unit circle, we would only need the x and the y coordinates since we know r is equal to 1. Let's use the unit circle to determine the values of each trigonometric function listed here. Sine 90 degrees, if we sketch that in standard position, would look something like this, where we can't actually form a right triangle. But that's okay, because now we know that sine theta is just equal to y on the unit circle. And we can see this is a unit circle, so sine 90 degrees would just equal 1. Cosine 90 degrees would equal x, which is 0. And tangent 90 degrees would be y over x, which would be undefined. For the cosecant of 180 degrees, the terminal side would be here. Remember, the cosecant function is a reciprocal of the sine function. And since sine theta is equal to y, this would equal 1 over y. Again, if we have 180 degrees, it would look something like this. So we're looking at this point, and the y coordinate is 0. 1 over 0, as we said before, is undefined. Now if we look at 270 degrees, we have our initial side here. Our terminal side would be here. So we're only looking at this ordered pair. Remember that cotangent is reciprocal of tangent. Tangent is y over x. So this would be x over y. Well, x over y would be 0 over negative 1, which is equal to 0. And our last angle is 0 degrees. So we're looking at this ordered pair. Remember, cosine theta is equal to x, so we know that cosine 0 degrees is equal to 1. Now, any angle that does have its terminal side on the x or y axis is called a quadrantal angle. Here's a list of all the trigonometric functions that are quadrantal angles for your reference. You may want to pause the video and take a look at them. Let's take a look at another problem now. A 60 degree angle intersects the unit circle at the point 1/2 square root 3 over 2. Let's go ahead and sketch that. And the question asks you to determine the values of the 6 trigonometric functions. So if you know it's a unit circle, this goes rather quickly. Sine 60 degrees would just be the y coordinate, so square root 3 over 2. Cosecant 60 degrees would be the reciprocal, or 2 over square root 3. We could rationalize this, but I won't do that now due to time. Cosine 60 degrees would just be the x coordinate. The reciprocal would be 2. And for tangent theta, we would have the square root of 3 over 2, and then 1/2 in the denominator, which does simplify nicely to the square root of 3. And then for a cotangent, we'd have the reciprocal of this, or 1 over square root of 3, and you may be required to rationalize this. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.